Hello, and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner. I am an independent contractor and a trainer. In this episode, I am going to cover CMake, and this is an episode that has been requested by a few different people. So what I'm going to do is give a basic overview of CMake, show how to set up a simple project, and then show how it can be used in a cross-platform environment. Now, CMake is one of these tools in the C++ world that kind of everyone loves to hate, but it really does its job better with more support than just about any other tool. And hopefully, I'll be able to show you what I mean by that in this quick episode. So we are starting here today with this CPP starter project that I have just created on GitHub. And as you can see at the moment, it has no files in it except for the license and the default README created by GitHub. And I created it 2 minutes ago. So by the time you see it, it will actually have more commits, and I can make no promises as to exactly what all will be in here at that point, but it is going to be a basic, just getting started with C++ on GitHub with CMake kind of thing that hopefully people will be able to fork and use effectively for when they're creating a new C++ project and want to use CMake with it. So I've switched over to my virtual machine, and I'm going to go ahead and clone this project. So let's go ahead and create our main.cpp. And this is going to be a really just simple hello world kind of thing, but at the same time, I'm kind of going to make it about as complicated as you could possibly make a hello world. So what we want to do is write a project that requires C++ 14, but we also want it to be hello world, so I hope you like this example. So, what is the best way to make the project require C++ 14? Well, obviously, the best way to do that is to use Lambda init captures. And, well, I like using Lambdas. If you watch this channel, you know that. So, let's do something interesting here. So, I am initializing the value out as a standard reference wrapper around the result value of calling the insertion operator on the cout global variable with the string hello space. And then our lambda is going to take no parameters. And then we need to dereference the reference wrapper to get back the reference with the dot get method. And then we will call world here and then invoke our lambda. And this does what we want it to do. So let's go ahead and make sure this project runs. And we can see with our default version of G++ that we have installed here, it compiles with no flags. That's because GCC has made C++ 14 the default now. But I do have a version of Clang on here that requires a C++ 14 flag to be passed to it. So let's double check that. And I should have called Clang++, but I get the same error regardless. And I can fix that error by setting the standard explicitly, and we have our hello world output. So now what we want to do is support this project with CMake. And we do that with a CMake list file. So the amount of boilerplate that's required in CMake is actually quite minimum. We just want to tell it what minimum version of CMake we require. And we're going to start with the version that we have installed, basically. And then we want to add our executable. And I'm going to call it intro for our starter project here. And we pass it what files that we want it to compile. And in this case, it's just main.cpp. And if you happen to notice this CPP being underlined here, that is because I have my spell checker in nvim enabled. So it is just saying that CPP is not a word. I should probably add that to the dictionary at some point. And now in modern CMake, we have the ability to tell the compiler which executables require which features. So I can say that I specifically need C++ Lambda Init Captures available. So CMake now has a database of which C++ features require which version flags on which compilers. So whatever compiler detects, it's going to know that it needs to set the C++ 14 flag here. So that is it. This is our starter to CMake, and this is our CMake list file. So we're going to go ahead and open a new tab and create a build directory. And we're going to run ccmake. I'm using ccmake specifically because it gives us a handy textual interface here to the project that we are configuring. So I hit C to configure, and it's going to automatically look for what compiler I have. And we can see that it found user bin C++ and user bin CC. And now to see that, I hit T, which is the toggle advanced mode. And we can see that down at the bottom. So I'm now looking at advanced mode. And I can change this compiler to be that Clang ++-3.7. And you might also notice that it has tab completion, so I can actually hit tab here and cycle through the options. Now, if I hit the C key to configure, it is going to automatically reconfigure itself, tell me that I changed the compiler and that it's reset all of my settings. That's fine. I'm going to toggle back out of advanced mode, and we have our basic project configured here. So now I can type make, and it makes it, and it gives us this pretty colorful output here. But we might be curious exactly what it did. So I can make clean, and using the make generator, which is the default that it uses on Unix, I can say make verbose equals one. It can also use Ninja and various other tools, but make files is the default. I tend to use make files by default for myself also. But we can see here that it automatically added the standard equals GNU++ 14 to add the C++ 14 support. And we can see that it generated an executable called intro. We can execute it and get our hello world output. So there you have it. That's at the core, the very most basic use of CMake. Now let's do a quick update to this because we want to make sure that we have all of our warnings possible enabled. So we can say add compile options. And on Unix, we know that we're going to have a compiler that supports at least these commands. And I am a huge fan of enabling as many warnings as you can, but let's start with this at the very least. We've got wall, wextra, and wpedantic. And we can save this and rerun our build over here with our verbose equals one so that we know what we're doing. It automatically reruns the configuration for us, and we can see that I misspelled pedantic, but we can also see that now the CMake is passing the correct flags for us to Clang. So we will correct our spelling. There we go. And now I highly recommend passing pedantic in this particular case, because as we may have noticed, CMake is choosing to pass for us GNU++ 14, which enables some perhaps GCC extensions to the language, but pedantic would warn us if we actually used any of those extensions. And there are other options in CMake to tell it specifically what version of C++ you want instead of what features you want. But if you want to go about it the most recommended way, you should look into this target compile features command and look at the list of supported features that are on there. It might be a bit behind what the standard has, but it's a pretty good list. So here is the list of supported features that you can set: auto, binary literals, constexpr, explicit conversion operators, lambdas, lambdas with init captures, etc. And we can see here on the CMake compile features page that another option is to set a property for the project saying that you want it to use the specific feature, standard 11, standard 14, standard 17, whatever. So we have our basic project set up, but we also want to be able to support Visual Studio. And if we pass it this wall, wextra, wpedantic, Visual Studio is not going to like that. So we can easily say If MSVC, then instead we want to enable compile options, add compile options dash W4, set the warning level to 4, and close it, and close our if block. And this is the extent of our CMakeList file. We can double check it. Everything compiles without a problem. And now we can check these in to our repository. And now back in our Windows environment in a Git bash, and you can use whatever Git client you want to, we can do a quick clone of that project also. I'm going to use the CMake GUI. And set an out of source build folder, that is. Now we should be able to hit the configure button. And CMake GUI will ask if we want to create that folder. We say yes. And we want to use the Visual Studio 2017 that we have installed, 64-bit. And it should automatically configure the project for us, which will take only a moment. We can see it detecting that the Visual Studio tools are installed correctly and that it has a working C++ compiler. And now we tell it to generate the build project, which it did that no problem. And then we can hit Open Project and it should come right up in Visual Studio for us automatically. And this is really where using CMake shines. If you are using multiple compilers across multiple operating systems, this kind of thing becomes quite trivial to do. We've just made this simple project, told it exactly what features are required from C++, and let it do its thing. So we can see that Visual Studio has our main.cpp that we created back on Linux, and we should be able to build this project. And CMake handled all the details for us. And we can also scroll back here and see that we got properly passed our dash W4, and there you have it. So that's a basic intro to CMake. It was slightly longer than I expected it to be, but you can see how it can easily be used for cross-platform development in C++. Be sure to subscribe, follow me on Twitter, and check out any of the links below.